On the surface, the Mangler is a pretty ridiculous concept. A giant machine that can't move on its own, that comes to life and kills people. But working in an industrial laundromat, Stephen King learned to fear machines like this, and his imagination came up with a story that's stronger and scarier than you might expect. It works so much better here than it did in trucks. But much like Lawnmower Man, it's not exactly filmable.
So it's probably no surprise that this is once again a New Line Cinema production.
While they did actually adapt the story this time, they also added in some elements that make it a complete mess.
Our main character, John Hunton, is changed from a regular cop into a detective with a chip on his shoulder. We eventually find out that his attitude problem is related to his wife dying in a car accident when he was driving. But leading up to that reveal, we just seem to have a total jackass as a protagonist, and it makes him very hard to like. His friend Mark in the story is turned into his brother-in-law in the movie, though otherwise remains accurate as a professor with an occult fascination. But the main addition to the story revolves around the owner of the laundromat named Bill Gartley, portrayed by Robert Englund in the film.
He's not much more than a name in the original story, but here he plays an important role. It's strongly suggested that his crutches have something to do with an incident that happened with the Mangler in the past. He also happens to be a total creep.
He pushes all the workers to their limits and insists they keep working even when people around them are dying. Even worse, he's also a pervert who has convinced a homeless girl to come and live with him and work at the laundromat so he can watch her take baths and who knows what else.
The events that happen in the short story to make the machine possessed by a demon also happen here. It's actually a pretty clever and believable chain of events.
Sherry, who is Gartley's niece rather than just an employee in the film, cuts her hand on the machine, exposing it to her virgin blood. Then old maid Miss Frawley drops some of her medication into the machine before being completely crushed inside of it. There's also an evil icebox being carried around at the same time that seems to cause some kind of transference between the two machines.
The icebox was mentioned in the story, but only as another example of a machine that seemed to attract death to itself.
Here it's delivered on orders from Gartley, and flat out attacks Mark and John as they investigate it.
It's alright, baby. Come on.
Why did Gartley have them deliver an icebox to someone who didn't want it, just to kill a boy who has no otherwise connection to the plot whatsoever?
So JJJ Picture Man can take a picture of the demon leaving it, I guess?
Yes. That is really the photographer's name.
There's this whole dangling plot about him and John having been friends, but then growing apart after John's wife's death. But none of it matters. At all.
Dangling plot threads are basically what this entire movie is about. There's the whole setup of getting the machine possessed, but then later we find out it's actually been possessed for years!
It has deals with all the elders in the town who killed off their 16-year-old daughters in order to get power and long life. First, it seems like Gartley is killing off Sherry to extend his power, but then he turns the homeless girl evil so she can join him. So maybe he's killing Sherry for her benefit? Is Gartley really that horny that he's gonna go through all this effort just for some random girl he lusts after?
Why am I bothering to figure out this movie?
Anyway, the climax starts off the same as the story, with Mark and John trying to exorcise the demon from the machine. Sherry is there, about to be sacrificed by Gartley, so they save her and end up feeding him into it instead. This final moment is pretty much the only part of England's performance worth watching.
My God, who art in hell? Cursed be thy name! You lying son of a...
Just like in the story, the fact that they didn't realize that Miss Frawley's medication contained deadly nightshade is what stops the exorcism from being successful. But here, it's a really stupid mistake.
John has been munching on the things all movie long, and apparently just takes pills out of a bottle from a dead woman without bothering to find out what they're made of. The Mangler becomes a transformer. It chases after John and Sherry after killing Mark. The scenery below the laundromat is nonsensical, and what happens, not much better. The movie tries to end with a twist, showing us that Sherry has taken over her uncle's place as the evil boss of the laundromat, but the film was just so stupid at this point, I couldn't care less what was going on.
Similar to Graveyard Shift, there is a complete absurdity to this film that bad movie lovers may enjoy. But for me, I just found it too tedious. It also goes too far off the rails to be considered a good adaptation. I cannot believe that they made not one, but two sequels to this film. Noel will suffer through them and then tell us all about it. For me, I'll be moving on to something much, much better. The Shining.